at all to try and get themselves a stage victory here this afternoon. The face of Ivan Besser there, Phil, in about third or fourth position is a picture of pain.
2 kilometers to the finish of a duo battle today. They deserve their rest tomorrow, and the mountains get steeper on Tuesday. Look at the faces now. This is so important, and look at this now. This is Kreuzinger, the man they should have watched out for. They're going to have to come after him.
Well, Kreuzinger made the move there. They've got a big advantage, Team Liquigas, because they know they've got two riders in this group. But immediately, Alberto Contador covers the move. Andy Schleck straight across there, and so too Cadel Evans. Cadel Evans, Phil, is riding himself into a yellow jersey at the end of today's stage because he starts the day with a 30-second buffer over Andy Schleck and a one-minute buffer over Alberto Contador. But it's right. All back together. Wait now for the attack to come from Ivan Basso if he's got the legs this afternoon.
Well, it's certainly not too early for Australia to celebrate the maillot jaune back in the camp and back on the shoulders of the world champion. He last wore the maillot jaune in 2008 when he finished second in the Tour de France. They can't get the time off him now to stop him getting yellow, and in any case he's got his braces hooked over the saddle of everybody. He's not going to get dropped. He's hanging on. Is that Gesink going?
Yeah, it's Robert Gesink, the man who won a big stage in the Tour of Switzerland, and he's got himself the gap. He's a fair way down in the overall standing, so they may not well respond to this move by Gesink as he goes off the front here. Maybe he's trying to wave the flag here this afternoon, Phil, for Holland, but covered there by Spain. It's almost a World Cup final at the top of the climb here.
It's a World Cup final on bikes here, as we see now. Gesink has been monitored out of this by Sanchez, who's got onto his back wheel. Contador is there, then comes Andy Schleck, then comes the world champion Cadel Evans, and now we've got Michael Rogers just slipping into the spot of bother here. He's got to hang deep now.
Well, Mick Rogers has got to hang deep and try and keep in contact with this group just in front of him. Almost he can touch the back wheel there of Ivan Basso, but this is now, they're really now starting to dig deep. This is Gesink again coming to the front. He wants a victory for Holland this afternoon, but he's covered by Spain. But this time it's Alberto Contador, and still Andy Schleck is sitting there. He's locked onto the wheel of Alberto Contador. Watch out for the win this afternoon. I think it may well go to Andy Schleck because he's feeling pretty good.
Well, I tell you, we're looking at the bridge, which means 1,000 metres to the finish. We are witnessing a battle duo here between the greatest climbers in the world. They are all in the pain barrier. There is no one holding anything back. They are really suffering now. It's he who gauges it, one last effort, will win the day. Even Gesink now has tried, and he's still trying, but they're right there behind him.
Well, Contador just looks so cool and collected there in second position. He's covered every acceleration. There's the move by Andy Schleck.
Schleck has gone with an incredible look at the reaction by Alberto Contador. And there's a slow reaction. Sanchez, the Olympic champion, has got onto the wheel of Contador. And Sanchez is going to go past Contador. He wanted the help. He didn't have it. Andy Schleck is gritting his teeth. This is her brother Frank. He left lying on the cobbles of northern France with a triple fracture of the collarbone.
Olympic champion coming across there, Sammy Sanchez. That's pushed Cadel Evans right to the back of this group with that acceleration. Don't forget, Cadel crashed at the 6th kilometre. Sammy Sanchez, Beijing in 2008. He was the Olympic champion. He's got Andy Schleck with him. But where is Alberto Contador? He's not able to respond to this acceleration. He's leaving the work, Phil, up to that man there, Roman Kreuzinger.
Well, I tell you what, they're going to take a lot of strength from this as the mountains are only just starting. They found the little hole in the armour of Contador, but there's the counter move, and Contador goes again here. But has Samuel Sanchez done enough at 400 metres from the line, or will Andy Schleck, who started the move, try and sprint by him? The pack are together and closing in. Gesink screws himself to try and get up there now, followed by Contador. A final kick now. This is like the Olympics reborn.
Well, Andy Schleck needs 30 seconds over Cadel Evans if he's going to think about getting himself the yellow jersey at the end of the day, Phil. But I think more interested in him is to try and get himself the victory. Sammy Sanchez has got the sprint. Andy Schleck's coming up alongside him. They're into the finishing straight. But you know, Sammy Sanchez is looking back to see whether or not there's going to be any acceleration from Schleck.
The crowd see the Tour de France and Avoria as a second kick by the Olympic champion. It's not enough. It just was not enough. Andy Schleck has won the battle today of Avoria. He beats Samuel Sanchez. Gesink, who started the final throws of the attacks, gets third. Fourth will be Kreuzinger. Fifth, I think, Contador. And Cadel Evans is the next wearer of the maillot jaune, and he wears it for Australia.
Mick Rogers coming in there at 20 seconds. He held tough over the final few kilometres. This will be Joachim Rodriguez coming in. You can see now that the time gaps, Phil, are going to start to appear in this Tour de France. 38 and a half kilometres an hour.